Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord. Good morning.
Morning, everybody. You guys start to come on.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praying
for the body of Christ. I know you're gonna have your way.
Be encouraged today. Right. Hallelujah.
Well, it's starting to come on now. Well, God bless you.
Good morning. Good morning, saints. Yes. We are praying. We are praying. We have not stopped praying. I'm praying for you
when I pray. Hallelujah. Well, praise the Lord. Somebody say good morning to us. There he is, Mr. Thomas.
Good morning, Dad.
Good morning, Daddy.
Good
Shabara, congratulations,
you.
Grandma.
Yes. Welcome to the club.
Welcome to the club. It is glorious. It's a glorious club. It is,
yes,
Shabara.
It is.
You'll see. Y'all see. You and Brother Perriman, y'all will see.
Yes.
You get to send that baby on back home. Yes, 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 yes.
Good morning, Dotsons.
The Dotsons
and
are
Loach
in the house.
Family. Hey, send me a text, a chat. I know L'Oreal had a birthday the beginning of this month. I want to make sure I get the date
Hallelujah.
Right.
Sister Jacobs Amen. And Sister Humes just came in. Trey Wheel is in the house. I mean, Trey Wheel is literally in the house. Trey Wheel is in the house.
Amen. Amen. Bless you, brother.
There goes Sister Martina.
Good
Martina
morning,
Harris.
Martina.
Birthday girl.
Yeah, she just had a birthday.
Birthday girl.
Happy birthday.
On Facebook looking all famous and stuff. I'm like, man, she all famous. She's famous.
Sometimes you don't know where to
famous.
Go, what to do, where to turn, but if you're listening,
we do not own the rights to this music. However, we do have a CCLI license, select songs, and this is one of the songs on the list.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So we just thank God.
Good morning, Greg.
We thank God. Greg Millen, so faithful. You're so faithful, man. Love you so much. So faithful, man. Because of y'all faithfulness, we just keep ratcheting this thing up.
Amen.
We keep ratcheting this online up, this online experience up, and we keep doing things to make it better and better every single week. Amen. Hi,
Amen.
Carla.
Good morning, Edmonds.
Yes.
Got Angela Harrison in the house.
Yes. Here y'all go. Listen.
Tennessee.
I'm
Love
praying
you.
For you. Do y'all pray for us?
Amen.
Do y'all pray for us?
We feel your prayers.
We praying for y'all. Are y'all praying for us?
We feel your prayers. Thank you.
The Bible said that the prayers of the righteous
yes.
availeth much.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
That Amen.
I love this part right here.
Yes.
Things going to get better. I don't know who that's for today. Hold your head up high.
Yes. Good morning,
this
butlers.
Is what he said.
Reverend Brown.
Things are going to get better.
Sandra Bowles. Good morning.
Things going to get better. Reverend Brown is going to get better.
Amen.
Oh, man, I'm feeling good, y'all.
Good morning, Deborah
yeah.
G.
Hold your head up. Rhonda Miller. It's going to get better, y'all.
Yes. Good morning.
Boy, I wish I could sing.
My
head up right here. Hold your head up. We got to go to work. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm just getting too happy, too carried away. Hallelujah. Did you say something to the butlers?
I did.
God bless you to the butlers. Love you guys. Love all
Amen.
Y'all today. Thank y'all for coming on. Some of y'all come on just a little bit later, and we can't get to everybody's name and stuff. And Brother Daniels out in Cali, man, we love you so much. All y'all that come on just a little bit later, we love you guys so much. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I am Pastor Edward A. Thomas, and of course, sitting next to me, always ride or die. For what, 30, how, what, 30, what we do this, 35?
So we did 36 years, darling.
And it was just the other day.
But we've known each other for 39.
It was
God
just the
is
other
so
day.
Good.
It was just the
God
other day.
God is so good.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for you being here and being by my side. Amen.
Amen.
I know that you didn't count on none of this.
Oh, but God 30, had a plan,
36
right?
36 years ago.
Aren't we talking about God's plan for us?
Amen.
To prosper us and not harm us? God had a plan.
Gives you a hope and a future.
Amen.
Good to see you, Sue Moore.
Good morning, Brother Van Dyke.
Elder
Bell is in the house. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. What you have for us first?
Well, first of all, I just want to welcome everyone to our online real-time worship experience. Just prepare your hearts for another inspiring word from God through the greatest motivator that I know, our very own Pastor Edward A. Thomas.
Oh, that's a lot to live up to.
And I want to just start with a psalm, Psalm 23, just reading in your ears. God, you are my shepherd. I lack nothing. You make me lie down in green pastures. You lead me beside still waters.
Oh, that's good.
You restore my soul. You lead me in paths of righteousness for your name's sake. Yes. And even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Listen. You prepare a table before me.
Where?
In the presence of my enemies. Okay. They got to watch it, y'all.
I'm about to shout.
Hallelujah. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup overflows. Overflows that you bless me so much.
My God.
Surely goodness and mercy will follow me. Another translation says, your goodness and love pursue me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
That's good.
Amen.
That's good.
Amen. So how can we say thank you enough to our online broadcast, to our faithful Antioch family? How can we say that we love each and every one of you enough? We cannot. Your God-inspired support, your prayers, your faithfulness, your stewardship as partners in this ministry has literally sustained us. And we say thank you and glory be to God. And because of this, we can continue to bring you a quality ministry broadcast right from our campus located here at 5430 South Washington in the great capital city of Lansing, Michigan. And as you always say, Pastor, we are getting better.
Better.
And so as we prepare to get better so that when we come back together, we are coming back better than before. Can you tell yourself that right now? I'm coming back better, than before. And we know that the parents, we got some parents, y'all got a week under y'all belt now. Y'all have been through a week of school.
Yes.
Hey, it might have been ugly, all right, but you made it.
Made it.
I remember watching some basketball games, and sometimes the wins were ugly.
Ugly.
But you know what? They were still a win. So however you made it, guess what? You made it through that week. So be encouraged. God is still on the throne.
Mama.
We can still praise God, and he has you in his hands. Just also yesterday, we were here for the Charles Terry Pantry.
Yeah.
And we served 70 people. I got the stats from Sister Petra. And I just want to say thank you to all the awesome volunteers who came to make sure that the people in Lansing have what they need in these trying times. Again, we're here every first Saturday of the month, so please help us spread the word and let so that we can help people in our community and bring hope. Also, we want to just give a shout out to the Wilsons who donated a second freezer.
Yeah.
It just showed up and
showed
we were like, we knew we had one freezer, but now we have two freezers.
Yeah.
And as Petra always corrects me, now we have 2.5 freezers.
Yeah.
Amen. But we just want to say thank you to the Wilson family for donating that freezer. And also, Petra has some ideas already on doing a fill the freezer event.
Yes.
For October, November, and December, so that we can be a blessing to the community again for the holidays. So just keep the faith.
Remember that
we're going to have some up and down days. We're going to have some disagreements, some disappointments. We might even shed some tears. But when it's all said and done, just remember, nothing can encourage you like the Word of God.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. First Lady, why don't you go ahead and pray for us while you got the mic.
Amen. So I do want to continue ask for continued prayer for the Berry family in their time of bereavement, the Miller family, of course, my family, the Mitchell family, the Walters. And then also just this week, Sister Fanny Mae Wilson passed away. She is the aunt of Sister Sandra Butler. So let's keep them in our prayers as well. Amen. Father God, we are your people.
Yes,
and we are called by your name. We humble ourselves and pray. Father, it is your goodness that causes us to reconsider, to turn, to repent, to go another way. And so, Father, today we seek your face, your presence, your favor. And we do this because we know we can expect a favorable response from you, Father God. We thank you that not only do you hear our prayers, but you forgive us and you heal us.
Yes.
And so, Father, merciful Father, creator of heaven and earth and all that is in the sea, we remind you that this is the day that you have made, and you have told us that we can be joyful and we can be glad in it. We thank you for eternal salvation through your Son, Jesus Christ. And we praise you for those who will come to accept you as Lord and Savior of their life, those who will be restored to you, Lord God, as a result of this message today.
Yes, Lord.
We magnify, glorify, and lift up your holy and righteous name. We bless and adore you. We are in awe of you, and your kingdom come, your will be done, that all would be saved, that none would be lost. We thank you for every seed, Lord God, that has been sown, every prayer, Father God, that has been prayed, every word of encouragement, Lord God. And we pray that Luke 36 and 38 manifests in the homes of all who hear this broadcast, that you will pour out blessings and opportunities that will overflow them and overtake them, that they don't even have room enough to receive.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you for your kingdom benefits today.
Yes.
We know that we are blessed, forgiven, provided for, protected, Lord God.
Yes.
We thank you for being our health and healing today. And we take authority by the word of God. We declare that our minds and our bodies are healed from any disease, any torment, Lord God. We thank you now for being our peace and our comfort. Thank you for meeting every need today. No lack.
No lack.
No lack, spirit, soul, or body.
Hallelujah.
We continue to pray for Pastor Thomas,
my God,
spiritual leaders across the globe today. Bless them as they bless us through your word, Father God. And Father, we pray for a manifested salvation in those that govern us, for our president, our governors, our mayors, lawmakers across the nation, Lord God. We thank you for trusted advisors that speak your word, that love you, Lord God. We thank you for transforming communities today. We thank you for unity and cooperation and collaboration. We thank you for the vote, Father God. We thank you that that vote,
hallelujah,
will be manifested, and that your people, hallelujah, would get out there, Father God, and see the importance and the power of the vote. We pray for our young people today, Lord God. You said it is you that have put knowledge in our hearts. And we thank you, Lord God, that you have good plans for them. You have put that knowledge in their minds, and that they are excelling in their education and in their lives. And then, Father, we close by asking you to bless our first responders and frontline workers and essential workforce, and bless and comfort the bereaving families, Lord God. Heal the sick and shut in. We praise you for healing testimonies that continue to come through, Father God. We know that you are still healing, Father God, and we thank you for bringing your protection and peace, Father God. We thank you in Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
We thank God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, First Lady, for the prayers
you,
of the righteous. The Bible said the prayers of the righteous availeth
much.
Availeth much. So
Amen.
We thank God for each and every one of you all today.
Hallelujah.
Yes. And for tuning in to the broadcast on today. Again, First Lady, I already talked about the pantry, so I can't, say it enough. Tune in to the Fill the Freezer. To the Fill the Freezer campaign, because
Amen.
We want to continue to fill to help people and fill voids in their lives. Amen.
Amen.
Also, before I go too far, Sister Butler said that Fannie Mae was her grandmother.
Yes, I misspoke. Please forgive me.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And listen, this is what I need you to do. Take a screenshot. Take a screenshot of this slide right now. We're going to have a back-to-school Zoom rally Thursday, September 17th at 7 p.m. That's the address on Zoom. That's how you click in. And so take a screenshot. We want all of our young people to be on that call, all the young people on the call, elementary school, middle school, high school, and college.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And as a matter of fact, the college students are going to be doing most of it.
Yes, they're doing a lot of the
me doing most of it. It's going to be the college students doing most of it. So make sure that your kids are tuned in. Amen. And it's not just kids that are in Lansing. Kids from all over. We got kids. We got kids in Maryland, the Singletons. Amen. Get it out to them and get it out to the kids in California. We want all the kids in Arkansas, wherever you are. If you're in high school, have them tune in onto the Zoom broadcast. It's going to be fun. And so we just want our young people to know that we love them. I'm going to give them a little small little word. Amen. I ain't going to be long. Like I said, most of the time they're going to spend with the college students. I'm gonna put it in their hands. Amen.
Amen.
It's gonna be good, y'all. Amen. So that's gonna be on Thursday, September 17th at 7 p.m. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, First Lady, this is your favorite part.
My favorite part. First of all, I need a correction. I said happy birthday to Elder Michelle Bell last Sunday. I was a few days early. So her birthday is actually on the 12th. But anyway, people who have had a birthday, Martina had a birthday on the 12th, Sad Mosley on the 8th, Felicia Curry on the 3rd, Devron Blackwell on the 4th. L'Oreal Salter turned 21 on the 5th. Happy birthday, L'Oreal.
She was one of our campers.
Yes.
One of our campers.
Yeah, right from the beginning.
Right from the beginning. Amen. Yeah. Happy birthday, L'Oreal.
Yeah, was baptized at Antioch.
Yes,
amen.
She was.
Then we have on the 16th, like I said, this is the real birthday for Michelle Bale.
She could be like Motley. Renee Motley, she celebrates all month.
All month, that's true. Kevin Edmonds has a birthday tomorrow. Happy birthday, Kevin.
Yep.
The 12th is Principal Marcel Carruthers. Happy birthday to you.
Coach.
Adriana Rocha and Lenoris Allen are our birday twins.
My Eastern people, tell Coach I'm looking for him. Coach,
amen.
Don't do Facebook too much. Tell Coach I'm looking for him.
Amen. And then AMJ has a birthday on the 24th. And finally, Sister Jackie Gibson has a birthday on the 27th.
Okay, I think you said that Michelle's birthday was the 12th?
It's the 16th.
Yeah, it's the 16th. Elder Michael says the 16th.
Yeah, it's the 16th. All right. Yep, I get it right here.
Amen.
All right.
Listen,
praise the Lord.
If we got your birthday wrong, we didn't do it on purpose. Amen.
We got the month right.
We got the month right. Amen. Amen. It's a lot of birthdays coming
up. Amen.
It's a lot of birthdays coming up. And so we just say happy birthday to all of the September birthdays. My mother passed away, but my mother had a birthday September 7th. Yeah. Amen. And so we got through it all, me and my sisters. Amen.
Amen.
Dad, we all got through it. Amen. My father called me up early in the morning and said, you know what day it is? I said, yeah, man, I know what day it is. Mama's birthday. Amen. So we thank God for the September birthdays.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to all of y'all. Amen. Hallelujah. All right. And so as we move on, prayer line, don't forget Tuesday, 6 a.m., Tuesday, 6 p.m., for prayer. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank God for our prayer team. Sister Loretta, they had a great prayer for the youth going back to school. So we
now
thank God for them.
Who turns one? She turns one.
I don't know who turned one. Amen.
Okay.
Hallelujah. Also,
Danny Franklin on the 17th. Okay.
Bible study. We're back this week. Bible study is back this week at 7 p.m. online. Amen. Listen, I've been leaking it out to the leaders. I'm not going to leak it out too much, but we're getting ready. We're going to be coming back to church face-to-face soon, not in the very near future, but we're going to be coming back face-to-face, and I won't make it public until I meet with all of the leaders.
Amen.
Amen. So I won't make it public till I meet with everybody. All right. But when we come back, Bible study is going to continue online. Amen. We will not be meeting face-to-face for Bible study when we do come back face-to-face.
Amen.
So Bible study is going to keep going online.
And
amen.
Pastor, I got one more birthday that I forgot to put in here. Uh-huh. This is for Hannah Johnson. Her birthday is on the 13th, which is today. So
amen.
Happy birthday,
they,
Hannah.
They all coming in left and right. Shavara got
Let's
a birthday.
See. Sandra Bowles, the 22nd.
They all coming in. They all got a birthday. Hey, happy birthday to all y'all. Amen. Lottie, Dottie, and everybody. Happy birthday to Lottie, Dottie, and everybody.
Let
all
me
y'all
get
who
this
got
right.
Birthdays.
Sandra. Okay, Sandra. So we got triplets now on the 22nd.
Amen. All okay. y'all born in September. Well, all y'all born in September, guess what? It's giving time.
Amen.
Don't get quiet now, y'all. Don't get quiet now. Y'all said all the birthdays. It's giving time, September. Amen. If God been good to you, amen, go ahead and be a blessing unto the body of Christ. The Bible says, give and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over. The Bible says that men will give in to your bosom. So we want to make sure that
God
we keep it flowing. Amen.
Giver.
That I said that we keep it flowing.
Amen.
You got to keep it flowing. Hallelujah. And so if you're making checks, make your check payable to Antioch Church. You can put that in an envelope and send it to our P.O. box. Amen. I'm going to send the scroll at the bottom of the screen so that you guys can see it and be able to govern yourselves accordingly. There it is right there. If you give Cash App, it's a money sign. Capital A-N-T-I-O-C-H 5430. That's the preferred way to give. Amen.
Amen.
Then the old school way of giving, of course, is the P.O. box. And then also PayPal, First Lady. They can sow through PayPal.
Yes.
And if they got to go through the website to do that, www.antiochoflancy.org. Click on give and then follow the prompts. Amen.
Amen.
Listen, I cannot say enough. I really cannot say enough how much of a blessing you guys have been to the body of Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. And you have said, you know what? Antioch is good ground. Antioch is good ground. And I'm sowing my seed to Antioch because it's good ground.
Amen.
And listen, we are just so, so grateful that you have chosen to sow your seed with
thank
us.
You,
we,
thank
hey,
you,
listen,
thank
and because
you.
You've done that, the church is ready. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Deacon Wilson, he got some things going on, so he's helping us today. And so, you know, he could tell you, church is ready. We're ready. We're just waiting on people. Amen.
Amen.
And now that the governor is starting to release some things and allow people to go
like
back into
gyms.
Different places. Yeah, the gyms.
Amen.
And so listen, so we're really taking a look at really hard. We're looking at how things are going to go with Labor Day. So we're really looking at those Labor Day numbers.
Wait for those
amen.
Numbers.
And so once those numbers come in, then we'll be giving some definite dates. Hallelujah. Give. Hallelujah. Listen, if you don't know what to sow a $20 seed. God always blesses the $20 seed in this house. And then if you want to top God, say, you know what? If he blesses the $20 seed, I'm going to sow $25. Amen. If you are a tither, continue to tithe. That's,
thank you.
Blessings come from
thank
that tithe.
Thank you for
amen.
Being obedient.
Some of you guys have been so obedient with your tithe. Amen. People send those tithes to the P.O. box. And so we thank God for you all today. Amen.
Amen.
So if you have your offering, come on with me. And wherever you are, come on, rise to your feet and just shake your offering at me. Say, Father God,
I thank you
for this offering.
I sow my seed
by faith.
And I fully expect
a hundredfold return
on my giving.
Lord,
I live
to give
in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Listen, now wherever you are. Begin to just speak
thank
that thing
God.
Into the atmosphere. Amen. Whatever you have need of, speak
Christ
into the
Jesus.
Atmosphere. Speak into the
no
atmosphere. Begin
family.
To just hallelujah. Tell God what you need, and begin to tell God what your requests are. Amen.
Thank you for tuition.
And I believe
hallelujah.
That God is going to see you and meet you, and listen,
thank
and
you,
He's
going
to raise you.
The
amen.
Meeting,
not only
expenses,
is He going to meet you, but He's going to raise
income.
You. in Jesus' name.
Reducing expenditures.
Well,
thank you for it all.
Y'all ready for the word today?
Amen.
I said, are y'all ready for the word today?
Let me get out the way.
Hallelujah. I thank you first, lady.
You're
going to come back.
Afterwards. Amen.
Hallelujah. All right.
Hallelujah.
Well, I got a word for y'all today. Turn with me to Jeremiah. Turn with me to Jeremiah, chapter number 18. Find Jeremiah, chapter number 18. Hallelujah. And we're going to take a look at verse 1 through 8. Jeremiah 18. We're going to take a look at 1 through 8. It's at the bottom of your screen. Jeremiah. Jeremiah. Hallelujah. Jeremiah, chapter number 18. And we're going to take a look at 1 through 8. Boy, I feel good today. Amen. I feel good today. I feel like God is really moving in the life of his people today. Hallelujah. Good to see you out there. I see you, Simon. Amen. I see you, Simon. I see all y'all out there. Amen. I thank you guys so much. Man, y'all are so faithful to the ministry and so faithful to what God is doing in this season. I remember Bishop Morton had a song. He said, Lord, whatever you're doing in this season, he said, don't do it without me. Amen. He said, don't do it without me. Hallelujah. So we don't want the Lord to do anything without us. Did y'all find Jeremiah? I'm just filibustering until y'all find Jeremiah. Y'all ready? Come on, stand to your feet. Now, if you're like Deacon Neil went out to Best Buy, bought him a connector. Now he's got us on the big screen. He probably got a 50-inch, 55-inch, 60-inch. I don't know what he got over there, but he got a big screen TV over there, and he got us on the big screen. Amen. And so if we're on the big screen, God bless you. If we on your cell phone, God bless you. If we are in or we are on your tablet, God bless you. Anyway, anywhere you have us, we say God bless you to that. Amen. Now stand to your feet. Hallelujah. Y'all ready? Let's read. This is the word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord. He said, go down to the potter's house, and there I will give you my message. So I went down to the potter's house, and I saw him working at the wheel. But the pot he was shaping from clay was marred in his hand. So the potter formed it into another pot, shaping it as it seemed best for him. Then the word of the Lord came to me and he said, can I not do with you, Israel, as this potter does, declares the Lord. Like clay in the hand of the potter, so you are in my hand, Israel. If at any time I announce that a nation or a kingdom is to be uprooted, torn down, destroyed, and if that nation, I warn, repents of its evil, then I will relent and not inflict on it the disaster that I had planned. Amen. Come on, just pray with me today. Father, we thank you, Lord God, for this word that we are receiving today. Father God, I pray, Lord God, that none of me, but I pray, Lord God, all of thee. Pray, Lord God, for the hearers of this word today, that they would take this word and hide it in their hearts so that they might not sin against thee. Father God, we'll be quick to give you the glory, the honor, and all of the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Now just grab your Bible, grab your word, just shake it at me and say, this is my word. See, if I receive this word with my mind only, then this word is dead to me. But if I receive this word with my spirit over my mind, then this word is life to me. I do not need any religious form or fashion. I need life in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, if you're going to roll with me in the chat line, somebody put in the chat line, safe in his hands. Put in the chat line, safe in his hands. Hallelujah. I'm ready to preach today. I'm ready to teach today. This message is not for everybody. Amen. It's not for everybody. If you're perfect, this message ain't for you. Amen. If you don't never do nothing wrong, this message ain't for you. If you have all the answers, this message is not for you. If you're on time all the time, this message isn't for you. If you're the best one in your mama's family, this message probably ain't for you. This message is really for us. The flawed. Hallelujah. I was going to entitle the message for flawed only. For flawed only. But I said I better not do that. I don't want to be too negative. But this message is for us who finds ourselves flawed. The book of Jeremiah is one of the largest of the three major prophets, with Isaiah and Ezekiel rounding out the top three. Today's text indicates that the prophet Jeremiah is sent by God to the potter's house. And he's sent there, y'all, to get a message for the people. It is assumed that the prophet is familiar with potter's work. The potter's house is what the potter did. It's not the potter's name. It's not like I'm going down to the Wilson house. I'm going down to the Thomas house. He's going down to the potter's house. He's going down to the place where he was making pottery. He was the potter. The prophet goes down there and he goes to get an extraordinary message from an ordinary task. I feel good, Reverend Brown. I feel good today. I want to teach and preach today a real simple word of encouragement to those that are less than. I said to those that are less than. You know, those that are less than perfect. I'm not talking about those that got these huge flaws, but you may have some little flaws, huh? But you're less than perfect. When I was in elementary school, I was fascinated with the power of the less than sign. When you look in math, it was a sign, and the sign looked like a triangle, and I was fascinated with this sign, and my teacher in elementary school, she taught us that the sign always gobbled up the greater number. Amen. And so I looked at this, and I guess I was a preacher from way back, because I really started looking at this and I started thinking about this. And I thought that the power of the sign, to me, the power of the sign really wasn't in the goblin, but to me, the power of the sign was in the point. I was always fascinated at what the sign was pointing to. If it pointed to the left, I always thought that it was heading for the front. Preach Thomas. If it pointed to the right, I always felt like it was advancing. Come on, somebody. If it pointed up, I always felt like it was destined for the top. Y'all ain't saying nothing to me. And if you took that sign and you said, I'm going to point that sign down, then that sign was destined to hit the bottom and come right back up to the top. I was always fascinated with the pointing of that sign. I know that the sign in math points left, and I know that it points right. I know it don't point up and down, but that was my preaching license right there. That was my preaching license right there. Life is really, y'all, all about perspectives. Man, it's going to help. I'm helping somebody today. I said life is all about perspectives. And God wanted the prophet to go down to the potter's house, Deacon Wilson, to see the potter's perspective. Jeremiah 1 says, this is the word that this is the word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord. He said, go down to the potter's house. He said, and there I'm going to give you a message. Watch this. Wake up, wake up, wake up and write this down. Wake up and write this down. We can only travel as far as our personal life lens can see. Hallelujah. I said that we can only travel as far as our personal life lens can see. We got to understand that the potter was a creator. I feel like preaching to somebody today. The potter sees things from the lens of a potter. Watch this. The potter is a creator. The potter is a designer. And a potter, and the potter sees things from that perspective. The potter sees things that other people can't see. Preach, Thomas. The potter calls things that are not as though they are. Potters walk by faith and not by sight. Creators see something that others call nothing. Creators see homes. They see skyscrapers. They see multi-dwelling homes out of dirt. That's what they see. That's what they see. The potter sees a beautiful vase or a beautiful vase. Depends upon which coast you live on. He sees that from a lump of clay. Somebody that creates furniture sees a couch from some wood. Somebody that is a great builder, and they build decks and outdoor things, they see things from just wood that others look at and say, it's just a piece of wood. But somebody says, I see a magnificent deck. Some songwriters will say that they can hear melodies when the birds are chirping. Huh? Some musicians can hear the rhythm of a song by being on the tracks of a train. I remember watching some rappers. They saw their pain of their neighborhood and they wrote some lyrics to the pain within their neighborhood, and they became millionaires expressing the pain in words from their neighborhood. Hallelujah. Sometimes you'll see artists, and artists will look at a wall, and the walls to them are a beautiful canvas for something beautiful to be drawn on. It's always amazing to me. I don't know about y'all. I don't get mad when I get stopped by trains. I don't get mad. I just sit back and wait to observe the beautiful artwork that people display on trains. I just feel like preaching to somebody today. I stop by to encourage somebody today to exercise your faith. It's okay to be able to see things that other people cannot see. I feel like preaching to somebody today. A crippled man went down to the temple gate called Beautiful, and every day this crippled man went down to that gate and he saw his healing. The Bible says that Peter and John went down to that gate and they saw that man and they encountered that man. And they saw what that man saw. They saw that man healed. The Bible says that he rose up and he walked. You got to exercise your faith. Put that in the chat, somebody. Exercise your faith. Exercise your faith. I'm going to do the best I can, Deacon Mason. I'm going to do the best I can. Exercise your faith. If you find yourself in a hospital room today, I need to talk to somebody today. I'm getting close to where I want to be. But if you find yourself in a hospital room today and somebody tune this broadcast in to you today, You got to begin to speak your healing. Somebody just began to just speak the healing for somebody in the hospital room today. Speak it. Join their faith with your faith. Somebody in the hospital room today, set the atmosphere. Call things that are not as though they are. You got to begin to just speak that thing and say, you know what? I'm walking up out of here. They might have wheeled me in, but I'm walking out. I'm walking out in the name of Jesus. Exercise your faith. I got to get going. I got to get going. When I was growing up and I was playing sports, it was just the time. I'm not criticizing nobody. I'm just saying it was just the time. When I was growing up playing sports, we didn't jump from team to team. Talk to me, Reggie Brown. You know what I'm talking about. We didn't jump from team to team. We didn't go and try to put together a super team. We rode with who was in our neighborhood. Come on, somebody. We didn't try to be a great team. We just said, you know what? We see the potential greatness of those that are within our own neighborhood. We saw greatness within ourselves. We believed that we could win. We believed that our neighborhood could win. I grew up in Detroit and playing for the Northwest Detroit Cougars, and we believed that we could win. Come on, somebody. I want us to receive this message today from the perspective of the potters. You got to believe in yourself. You got to believe that you can win. You got to allow your spirit to look at your situation through the eyes of faith and say, I know that the chips are stacked against me, but by faith I shall rise. The prophet could have told God, God, I know what the potter does, but he humbled himself and he went to see the message through the eyes of faith. Let me give you these two things, Greg Millen. Let me give you these two things and step out of everybody's way. Write this down. Number one, I'm valuable, but I'm flawed. Write that down. I'm valuable, but I'm flawed. I'm flawed. I'm flawed. So I went down to the potter's house and I saw him working the wheel, but the pot he was shaping from clay was marred. He said the pot was marred in his hands. And the potter formed it into another pot, shaping it as it seemed. Jeremiah said that he saw him working on the wheel, and he said that the pot he was shaping was marred in his hands. That's what he said. In other words, the potter realized that there was a flaw in the pot. Listen, the potter said, I got to shape this thing. I got to take it and I got to make it into something else. I feel real good today, y'all. Understand something. It's easy to always point out the flaws in others. And it's just as easy to point out the flaws in yourself. It's amazing to me how powerful we have allowed the word but to become in our lexicon. When someone begins to discuss vision that somebody else cannot see, the other person's response is not an agreement. The other person's response is, yeah, but. Y'all ain't saying nothing to me. But. They may not know nothing about pottery, but they got a yeah, but on them. Yeah, but, yeah, but, yeah, but, yeah, but. I know that it is a flaw in this clay, but why you want to start all over again? Yeah, but is the killer of dreams. I'm preaching better than y'all saying amen. One of the things that robs most people from reaching their full potential is the obsession with your own personal flaws. People obsess over their own personal flaws. Some folks allow I'm going to say something here. Y'all better wake up and write this down. Some folks allow unperfect people to point out flaws in them. I know I got some flaws. Y'all ain't got to tell me. I know I got some flaws. Thomas, I need to tell you about you. You don't need to tell me about me. I know about me. You ain't telling me nothing I don't already know. I know I got some flaws. But you know what? God knows I got some flaws. God knows you got some flaws. But God uses me and God uses you anyhow. Boy, I feel like running around this church. He uses you anyhow. Hallelujah. God knows about your comings and going. God knows you. But God keeps on blessing you anyhow. Somebody put this in the chat. Say, carry on. Carry on. Carry on. Put that in the chat. Carry on. Carry on. Carry on. The potter uses that imperfection of the pot. But watch this. He continues. Deacon Mason, he continues. Brother Daniels, he continues. He continues. He carries on. Come on, write that in the chat. Say, carry on, carry on, carry on. Nobody is perfect. Carry on. You ain't perfect. Carry on. The only person that you got food in the thinking you perfect is you. Carry on. I've come to let somebody know that the only perfect person I know is a man by the name of Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ said it like this. He said, I've come so that thou might have life and life more abundantly. Carry on. Carry on, brother. Carry on, sister, with your flawed self. We know you got flaws, but we love you anyway. We know you got flaws, but we love you anyway. Nothing is perfect. No car is perfect. No house is perfect. No clothing is perfect. No person is perfect. We all got some flaws. One eye bigger than the other. One foot bigger than the other. One hand bigger than the other. Somebody say, such and such got a big nose. Such and such got a little nose. Such and such got big ears. Such and such got little ears. Ain't nobody perfect. Carry on. Carry on. Hallelujah. All right, I'm almost done. Number two. Write this down. A masterpiece. Oh, man, I feel like preaching. A masterpiece. A masterpiece. Jeremiah 18:6 said, and he said, I cannot do with you, Israel, as the potter does, declares the Lord. Like clay in the hands of the potter, so are you in my hand. If at any time I announce that the nation or kingdom, watch this, brother bishop, that is uprooted, torn down, and destroyed. If that nation I warn repents of its evil, then I will relent and not inflict it on the disaster that I had planned. The Lord said, you're like clay in my hands. Watch this, y'all. I can uproot you. I can tear you down. Hallelujah. I can squeeze you. I can spin you. I can press you down. You're clay in my hands. I can cause disaster to await you. I can cause that disaster to stop. But here's what he said, y'all. If you repent, preach, Thomas. The modern church, Sister Tina, the modern church, we don't like to hear that word. We don't want to talk about repenting. Some churches are busting at the seams with people because they shy away from preaching biblical words like repent. We don't want to talk about repenting no more. Repent means to turn and go the other way. We wouldn't have to repent if we was doing everything right. But we're not doing everything right. So sometimes we need to say, Father, forgive me. For I don't even know what I'm doing myself. Hallelujah. He gave us the ability to confess our sins and to repent. Somebody ought to just repent today. Somebody ought to just fall. Tell the Lord, Father, I fell short of your glory. And I repent. Put it in your vocabulary. I repent. I'm coming back home to you. The prodigal son taught us how to repent. Sandra Bowes, the prodigal son, taught us to come back home. Today, because of COVID-19, we got some young adults. If I'm talking about you, just keep looking straight ahead. We got some young adults because of COVID-19. They find themselves coming back home to mama and daddy's house. They find themselves having to go back into their old bedrooms. It's humbling to come back to mama and daddy's house. A grown man, a grown woman, 25, 26, 27, 30 years old, having to come back to mama or daddy's house. But here's what God gave me. The truth is, it's safety at home. You're safe in mom and daddy's hands. It's not always comfortable at mom and daddy's house, but the truth is, it's safety in the parents' home. God sent me by here to tell somebody today, when you come back into the kingdom of God, that God says, you're safe in my hands. I feel like preaching, y'all. You're safe in my hands. It's safety in the presence of God. It's security in the presence of God. It's peace in the presence of God. Hallelujah. None of us like to be squoze. I'm coming home now. None of us like to be mashed. None of us like to be wet. None of us like to be constantly spun. But watch this, Deacon Butler. But when God is finished squeezing you, mashing you, wetting you, and spinning you, this is what God sent me to tell you. When he is done with all that, he has a masterpiece. Hallelujah. Tell somebody, put that in the chat line. I am a masterpiece. Put that in the chat line. I am a masterpiece. Keep watching. I'm a masterpiece. I'm a masterpiece in the making. Put that in there, y'all. I'm a masterpiece. Good stuff takes time to become a masterpiece. We're about to go home. I remember growing up when my mother used to cook Thanksgiving dinner. And my mama, my daddy, and them, they out there, they know I'm telling the truth. My mama had this big old gray pot. She'd take that turkey, she put that turkey in the pot, and she put that turkey in the pot at night. And she would cook that turkey slow. Y'all ain't saying nothing to me. She cooked that turkey slow, and that turkey would cook all night long. I heard somebody one time on TV advertising that you could cook a turkey in a microwave. I said, the devil is a liar. Mr. Thomas, that's why I don't eat at everybody's house. You can't cook no turkey in the microwave. Listen, you might could cook a turkey in the microwave, but Ed ain't eating it. Come on, somebody. But my mama, she cooked that turkey, and she cooked that turkey slow, and that turkey would cook all night long. As I got a little bit older, I learned that my daddy used to be creeping in that pot at night. Come on, somebody. We would see little bits and chunks out of the turkey. Daddy say he was trying it. Come on, somebody. Because that turkey was cooking slow and it was smelling good. I don't know who I came to preach to today, but God sent me by here to tell somebody that when that turkey was done, it was a masterpiece. My daddy take this big old knife, he cut that turkey, and all that juice starts sliding out that turkey. Y'all ain't saying nothing to me. I hope I'm making y'all hungry right now. And then I'm doing my job. But that turkey was good. It was a masterpiece. That turkey came out and be falling off the bone. I stopped by to tell somebody today that you are a masterpiece in the making. Somebody say, I ain't married yet. That's because God ain't found the perfect person for you yet, because you're a masterpiece in the making. He can't turn masterpieces over to everybody. Waiting on a masterpiece takes some time. Gold can't be rushed. Gold got to be tried in fire. I feel like preaching to somebody today and just letting somebody know that you're a masterpiece. You're safe in his arms. We call Jesus, the master. And you are peace that's safe in the master's hand. Hallelujah. There's a church open. You come as Camp for Baptism. You come on your own Christian experience. You're a masterpiece. You're a masterpiece. I wish I had some folks. Wish I had some folks that would put that on the screen. Did they put that on the screen? Yeah, I see some people. They said they're a masterpiece. I'm a masterpiece. Amen. A masterpiece. Might have some flaws, but I'm a masterpiece. Hallelujah. I remember one day when my mother was alive, and y'all know it was my mother's birthday, so I'll be thinking about this stuff in September. But when my mother was alive, this is what I told my mother, Sister Jacobs. I told my mother, I say, right now, Mama, I say, I'm just an old lump of coal. But I told her, I say, but Mama, I'm going to be a diamond one day. Y'all ain't saying nothing to me. It's about perspective. It's about perspective. You're going to make it out of COVID. You're going to make it. And you're going to come back better than ever. Listen, if you accepted, if you need to accept Jesus Christ as Lord and your Savior of your life, come on, stand up. Stand up in front of your cell phone. Stand up in front of your TV screen. Wherever you are, come on, stand to your feet. Wherever you are, repeat this prayer after me. Say, Father God, say, forgive me of my sins. I forgive those who have sinned against me. Father, you said in your word, if I confess with my mouth and believe in my heart that Jesus Christ rose from the dead, that I shall be saved. So, Lord, I believe it, and I confess it, and I accept you into my heart today. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Yes, you are flawed. Yes, I'm flawed. I may not have no big flaws like people can see, or, you know, I'm an X this or X that, but I'm not perfect. Amen. I'm not perfect. And guess what? And neither are you. Amen. So let's do us a favor. You let me off the hook and I let you off the hook. And we carry on. First lady, you coming on back? We carry on. Amen. We carry on. We carry on. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I hope y'all received something today. Did y'all get something today? Amen.
Amen. I'm Hallelujah. Not perfect.
Not perfect.
Hallelujah.
And you still hang out with me.
Guess what? Yeah. But God uses us. And God is looking for imperfect people, hallelujah, that he can anoint.
Amen.
That he can bless.
Yes.
Even though they're flawed.
Even though they're flawed.
And we can be safe and secure in God.
In God. Amen.
Amen. That was awesome, Pastor.
You could build a brand new home and have a whole lot of flaws. We've had several new homes built.
Yes.
And then you look at the house and the house looks great. And then you keep living.
Over time.
And you say, that wall's crooked.
That's right.
That wall is That's crooked. Right. That light, those two lights are hung the same way. Imperfect. Flaws.
Perfect
Amen.
For God. Hallelujah.
For God. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Well, that's all I have for today. Amen. Doing good. Amen. Hey, we've been getting out on time. Hallelujah. We've been doing good. And,
Amen.
And it's intentional.
1 hour
it's intentional.
Of power.
It's intentional. I'm intending. I told Deacon Mason, he know, all my deacons know, they know that we've been talking about 1 hour of power for a couple years
yes,
now.
Yes, we have.
And God is in the, is in the blessing business.
He's doing
and he's
it
doing
right
it.
Now.
Amen. And Amen. So when we come back, we're still going to be our power.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I can do it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Well, that's all I have for today.
Thank
Amen.
You, Brother Trey.
Thank you, Trey.
For everything
Amen.
Today.
We got. I don't
Amen.
Know if y'all can see, but Trey got some lights going for us in the back.
Amen.
Amen. In the back there, he got some lights going for us in the back. And they could move around, but he said he ain't going to move them around because he don't want everybody to be dizzy.
Right.
So we're going to just keep them steady like that.
Amen.
Amen.
I like
so that's
like
all
that.
We have for today. Amen. Listen, may the good Lord keep you. May heaven smile upon you. That is my prayer.
Amen.
God bless you guys. Love you guys. Y'all have a good evening. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Remember, you're a masterpiece
you
in the making.
You are a masterpiece. You're a masterpiece. Say that out loud wherever you are. Say, I'm a masterpiece.
I'm a masterpiece in the making.